Welcome to Weld.com. Today I got my buddy Bob from FrankenFab.
Yo.
And we're going to continue on this follow-up of TIG welding. Today, it's not going to be in the easy flat position, Bob.
I'm freaking out, man.
Come on, man.
Vertical up, man. Got some 3G going on, and we got, you know, our same standard operating utensils here we'll go over, but I'm a little bit nervous about TIG welding anything, first of all, and then secondly, vertical on camera. So, Paul, why don't you tell us what we're working with here?
So, easy, Bob. It's going to be okay, man.
Melt tools. This camera is going to be pretty rad, too. Please don't bust my butt about my shaky TIG hand. So.
Right. So, we got the melt tools on the TIG rig there. Of course, we're going to use 3/8 thick carbon steel A36 plate, beveled at 45 degrees, ER70S6. So, the diameter we're going to use is 3/32 1/8, and of course the E3 1/8 tungsten, along with the Lincoln Aspect 375, and we'll show you the settings as we go, because we're going to be maybe coming down a little bit or maybe going up a little bit on settings. We ain't sure, are we, Bob?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I have no idea, so we're going to find out. Also, luckily I don't have to use the foot pedal this time, so I can eliminate a little bit for my hand foot action, but I'm excited, man. It's lift arc, right? That's what we're running this time. So
I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
We'll find out.
So let's get started.
Let's do it.
So here's what we're gonna do, Bob. That's the plan. I come up with this plan. I don't know if you like it or not, but I figured you'd prep all the coupons since you're gonna be majority welding them.
All right.
Yeah, you like that?
Sure.
Okay.
I guess.
So anyway.
Sounds like a great plan.
We'll put a knife edge on it. 45 degree knife edge, no landing, and then we'll tack it up either 1/8 or a tight 1/8 gap, and then use 1/8 wire for the root.
All right.
So we get good penetration.
All right.
So if you want, I'll weld like 2 inches of it, and then I'll let you
finish it out.
Then you wash and you finish it out.
All right.
On every pass.
Sounds good.
So if I screw it up, you're gonna fix it?
Absolutely.
Okay, let's get started.
Might have a landing on
it. Yeah, so let's get started.
That's why we use Ferd products for that killer bevel.
So as you can see, we tacked up the 3/8 plates with a 1/8 gap wire, and now we're going to put it in the positioner. And what we're going to do, I'm going to start at the bottom and demonstrate to the 2-inch mark. And then FrankenFab is going to take over.
We'll see. I'm excited, so, see, man.
Yeah.
Nervous.
But nervous.
I'm nervous, bro. I'm just nervous.
This is just a test.
People,
this is just a test of the broadcast station. This is just a test.
No, dude. Just a test. Just a test.
Other broadcast station.
All right.
All right. Turn the broadcast off. You gonna be okay?
I'll be fine.
All right. Let's get started. So as you can see, I said earlier we're using the Aspect 375.
This guy over here, man.
Can't see nothing?
No, you making it look like it just buttered. Just butter and bread over here, homeboy.
So, Bob, before we get started, here's the plan. So, of course, you're going to heat up where I left off, where I pulled out.
Right.
Get it nice and warm, and then come in with your wire, or have your wire right here. Get it right. Nice and warm, and then dip the wire right into the puddle and twist it.
All right.
And keep twisting it, just slow back and forth, and keep a little bit of downforce on it, a little pressure, and work that tungsten back and forth as you go up the bevel. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So another educational thing is really important. Take 3 deep breaths
and
make sure you blow out
right All right. Let's do
not
it.
Not that hard. I know you can do it. You've did it before. So anyway, let's get started. What do you think, Bob?
Let's do it, man.
All right.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Am I ready? I'm ready now.
Dip the wire right in it. And twist it. Go real slow and twist it. There you go.
How am I doing, man?
Looks good. Looking good. Just keep doing that. Just keep that same rhythm. Slow down a little bit. Pull the wire out. There you go. All right. Come on out of it.
Failed.
So to tell the tale, Bob. So I did the first 2 inches. Bob did the last 5 inches. So as you can see here, we should have started out a little bit lower on that tack and heated it up. And then, like I said, when you get into it and just twist that wire and push a little wire to it, it'd have made it a little bit flatter. But it made the tie-in. It's not what we wanted exactly, but...
So it may pass or it may not?
It's not going to pass. That's under flush.
All right, so then I would, in real world, I would have to grind that out on the other side and add more material, correct?
Right, yeah, push a little wire to it. If the guy give you another chance. Anyway, So you picked up and started doing really well. You know what I'm saying? And we're going, doing pretty good, 100%. You know, a little bit over flush is about all we wanted to do, you know, on the root.
Okay.
And we got a little heavy spot, you know, I think you kind of sped up too fast, or the wire, you pulled the wire out. So anyways, you overcame that and kept going. And then we got this dingleberry, Bob.
Dingleberry.
I'm going to call that Bob the Dingleberry.
Oh, man. Come on, bro.
So anyways... We got a little heavy spot there, but I think that's when you pulled it out and you jammed the wire back in it because you were kind of getting a little nervous.
I was getting scared.
Is that what it is? I don't believe it's scared, but anyways, scared, we can overcome that. You know, if we wanted to fix it, you want to just roll on with it.
I mean,
we could grind that thin to make that tie in, or you could grind that out and maybe it'll pull it back, you know. But, you know, just like this is just a follow-up. And it's not a test or anything. We're not going to cut it and bend it or etch it or do any of that NDE to it.
Well, let's move forward, man. And then
let's just cover up.
We might end up having to have a whole video of Bob fixing his own mistakes, right?
There you go. So what we'll do is we'll move on to the hot pass. And of course, you know, the hot pass filler and then the cap. So let's get started. So as you can see, I said earlier, we're using the Aspect 375 by Lincoln Electric, of course. So we'll start up here on the polarity. So we're using reverse polarity, and you go down to the process, and we're using TIG, of course, lift arc. Got the output on, not using the high freak. So on the root, as you can see, we started out at 120 amps. So we're gonna go the hot pass, and I'm gonna jack it up. What are we going to, Bob? 130, 135?
Totally.
All right, how about 132 and a half?
Let's call that 133.
133? American. All right, we'll go to 133.
Oh man, I see myself struggling with this.
See, the thing about it is you gotta twist the wire to it. See, I'm twisting it?
Yeah.
How I'm filling it up?
Yep, and rolling it kind of back and forth a little bit, or
yeah,
kind of.
Well, I twist it every time I come across that wire, I twist it. See,
yeah.
So it adds to it. See how it's filling up the sides?
Yes, sir.
Get it hot. Get it nice and hot. There you go. Now dip the wire in there. You're gonna have to put the wire right in the puddle. There you go. Now twist it. Twist it. Now you can't dip it. You gotta stick it right there.
What's that?
You can't dip it. You gotta keep it right in the puddle and then twist it. Turn the wire straight up, Bob.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, there you go. Straight up like this. Straight up just like this. Now hit it. Now twist it and move it back and forth. Twist it.
Yeah.
Move it back and forth. Twist it. Move it back and forth.
Yeah.
Yep. You got to keep that wire right in there, though. Keep it right in the puddle. That way, when you twist it, it melts it.
Yeah, I'm like, I can't feed the damn thing. There we go. I don't think I'm built for TIG welding, bro. I don't know.
What do you think?
I don't want to talk about it.
You don't want to talk about it?
Let's just move on.
You don't want to talk about it?
Let's talk a light. Let's shine a light on it.
How about we shine a light on it and talk about it? How's that? Come on. How about we do it?
Come on now.
There it is. So anyway, as you see, we started out, and I'm saying we, Bob.
We
started out pretty good.
We were doing really good.
To the 2-inch mark.
Till we tagged in.
Bob tagged in. And took off running with it. It's a little uneven, but, you know, it's for beginners.
Yeah, I don't know. It's not great at all. And, I don't know. I'm not happy with it. I do like this camera that's on here. It's a great camera. It's super. I really do like being able to watch the fact that I'm messing up in my puddle, but I need to take a break from it. So I asked nicely if we could just take it off and let's see if I can't fix my mistakes with it off. And if I can, then I'm gonna maybe not use the camera so much. But if I can't, then it definitely wasn't the camera. It's me.
But we know the audience loves him. The puddle shots and
yeah, they're really nice.
Right there in the melt camera does a great job. But Bob,
when they're nice, they really look good. But when they look like that,
so we'll get started back. We're gonna let Bob fill in his lumpity bumpity road right here from here up and get it flush, and then we'll come back and cap it. So you ready to get started?
Let's do it.
You gonna walk the cup?
I think so. I didn't mean to touch that. I don't know, man.
You know, you can go like this too. Just like this.
Yeah, I seen him doing it like that, but I never seen myself doing it like that. All right. Well, we're going to try it.
Just go real light. Don't try to grind it in there, you know what I'm saying? Just go real light with it.
Yeah.
Pick up the pace a little bit faster. There you go. Make sure you stick that wire in there. Try not to go too wide. If you're going to go any wider, go to the middle, not to the outside. There you go. Speed up a little bit. Get almost to the top and just pull out.
Dip and then pull out, right?
So we got the fill in at 140, and we're going to let it cool down. And we'll probably keep it about 140. We might turn it up a little bit. What do you think, Bob?
I'm for it.
Keep it at 140?
Yeah.
Well, we'll see how it goes. So before we get started capping it, I switched it out to a jumbo number 10 gas lens. which I love to use.
Me too.
I'm trying to throw it off on Bob. So just like he said, me too. I agree. He'll like it.
I'm for it.
Yeah, he'll get a little taste in his mouth. And he'll be like one of them ravishing dogs. He just got to have that number 10 cup. Anyways, going back to the coupon or the test piece, I'm going to start up a little bit, and I'm going to run the first pass all the way up. We're going to put a two-pass cap on this. So Bob says the camera's not messing with him. He's going to make his look better than mine. So we'll see at the end of the
day. That's what I said. I totally said that. We're going to run it up.
Well, he's got good confidence.
Like. We're going to run it up, see what it looks like right, and then Paul's going to do his.
Or we're going to flip it around and see the real deal.
Yeah, exactly.
Or put my coupon up there and take yours down.
Yeah.
What's up? So I ran my side, and you know what? For as old as I am, freehand, I know the audience, you guys are way better than this, but you know, for my age and everything, I think it looks okay. What do you think, Bob?
It's clean, it's slick, man. I'm about to mangle it up right now.
It's all right for an old man with freehand. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to do. I'm about to just
put the icing on the cake. Would
mangle it up.
Just smack it up a little bit.
Yeah, let's do it, man.
Yeah, let's do it.
No more waiting. Let's get this over with.
Let's weld it out. Weld that wire, man. Let's get moving fast. This is getting undercut, eh? I guess we'll find out what it looks like when we get done. So, Bob, here we are. We're doing pretty good.
Well, I did freehand it kind of all the way, I guess if you call it freehand. I kind of just drug my cup back and forth on it. I didn't really walk it, but anyways, you can take over from there.
So, like me and you agreed on, I'd run the first pass all the way up to the top, and then I let you take over and run the full pass all the way up the other side. And it started out pretty good. And then we kind of got up here. But just like you were saying, you freehanded it for a little while, then you started walking the cup or bouncing the cup around on that number 10 that you liked.
Yeah, I definitely liked the 10 cup, you know, a little better. Seemed a little more
in control,
ease
huh?
for me, but yeah. But obviously, in control.
Well, the thing about it is
lack of better words.
That's when I kept saying, make sure you stay on your wire, move it over to the right a little bit. That way you don't have any undercut. So we got a little bit of undercut. But, you know, the main thing about this whole follow-up TIG thing, Bob, is to get you up to speed and get you learning.
Yeah.
And I think you're progressing pretty good, you know.
I'm trying, man. I'm trying. Yeah.
But anyway, you know, it is what it is, and you learn from your mistakes, and practice makes perfect.
Exactly.
You know?
And I got a lot of mistakes to practice on.
So you guys, you throw these constructive comments in the bottom box there, and
yeah, let me know how I'm doing. Keep your negative comments to yourself.
So we had fun today. What do you say, Bob?
It was fun, man. It was a little nerve wracking, but it was fun. I had a good time. I love it coming out here, even when I make a fool of myself. But I know I'm getting better. Eventually, it'll show.
Bob's doing very well. So anyway, thanks for watching today. You know, be sure to connect with us directly at Weld.com and download our app. If y'all didn't know, it's Weld, WLD.
Check out our e-learning curriculum. It's developed by professionals for welders of all skill levels, including myself. And go on and showcase your business. And we have all kinds of content on this app. So let's check it out. If you don't already have it, you definitely need to get it. Join the global welding community at Weld.com.
See you on the next one.